Welcome to the 16th Sunday in Ordinary Time. We reflect on Jesus' parable of the weeds as in Matthew 13, 24 to 30. In this parable, we read of a problem some farmers faced when they had unfriendly or unjust business dealings. An enemy would sow weeds in their fields. This could cause a great problem, as it could take years to get rid of. Does this affect the reality of today's life? Let's see. Now, a weed is a plant with the same sort of stalk and green color as wheat while growing. But when full grown and ripe, it has long ears and produces black and poisonous grain. Of course, if the poisonous grain were allowed to ripen fully, the seeds would fall into the soil and produce another crop of poison the following year, causing a perennial problem. With harvest time not far off, the servants began to notice that as the crop came to the last stage of growth, some began to look different, as the heads began to form and grow longer than the wheat. They quickly told the owner that they must pluck out the weeds before the seeds develop. The problem, though, is that the weeds are rooted into the same ground as the wheat and probably intertwined with the roots of the wheat. And pulling up the weeds would damage the growth of the wheat as well. The problem was resolved by the master's wise decision to wait until the harvest, and then the separation of the wheat and the weeds would come. In the Bible, the parable of the weeds follows right after the parable of the sower. That parable was about the work of the evil one seeking to hinder a person from coming to fruitfulness in the reign of God. The seed sown represented the word of God planted in the ground of a person's heart and his response to it. The disciples were puzzled by the parable of the weeds because it sounded so similar to the parable of the sower, and yet they are related. So why would an enemy want to ruin a perfectly good field by sowing weeds? Probably there is hatred towards the field owner with a desire to spoil the harvest. Through his poisonous plants, the enemy wants to gain control of the field. In other words, the world, which is represented by the field. Just as God has his servants to accomplish the purposes, the evil one also seeks to employ individuals for its aims and goals. The most effective way Satan can destroy the plans and intentions of God is to infiltrate, deceive, and ultimately destroy. Our enemy does his best work when undetected, as is said in verse 25, when they were sleeping. Satan's most effective strategy is to appear as an angel of light, where people are deceived into thinking he or she will do good when actually they plan to do evil. He represents himself as one that looks like a savior. However, there is one thing he cannot accomplish. He cannot produce good fruit. In the end, his deception will be apparent when the fruit of the weeds is exposed. There is a product or an outcome of his work that will yield a bitter crop. This strategy has always been the enemy's plan: to permeate, intermingle, infiltrate, and control the world system and humankind. Here lies the thought of intermingling the root structure of the weeds with the wheat. The weeds will grow together with the wheat undetected until things happen on the world scene. These events, some referred to in prophetic scriptures, will make it evident to discerning Christians. Those manipulating world events and referred to in scripture as weeds. Many do not have the time to stalk their daily lives enough to think critically about how the world system is set up today. We blindly accept the spoiling of our time, labor, energy for big corporations and those who steal from the rich to enrich those hidden behind the curtain. Look at today's world events. We are on the threshold of a third world war. Countries struggling to save their democratic rights. The poor are losing their human dignity at the feet of the selfish rich. The weeds have been sown. And if we do not open our eyes quickly, we could be trapped. So stay alert and stay tuned to your conscience. Until next Sunday, wish you a wonderful week ahead.